Hi there, it's time for a bit more skidding. Today we're in Seno Park Woods under the direction of Mr. Cook, who's kindly sold me some Douglas. You can see here that he cares loads about the Douglas fir, and you know, this is regrowth, self-set. We have to be very careful when we come and extract anything from here that we don't hit any of the regeneration. Kindly he comes through and spots them and marks them up. So here we go. Somewhere near the end here, you can just see the chainsaw in the distance, about 120 feet away, something like that. It was a fairly tight fell to not make any damage on any of the others. As you can see, it was a bit of a squeeze, but I did it without knocking the top out of anything else, maintaining a harvest for the future. We'll do the log walking shot. As we wander down the log, see the generation of sycamore around us. One of the only trees that's not being harmed really by much, could end up as a highly calorific biomass tree for the future. We'll see. Quick shot of the butt. Can't beat a good butt shot. Bit of a sway in it, but we're not too worried about that because I need 16 foot sections for building the barn back at the farm, and also boarding for the house. So I'll mark them all out and then we'll go from there and then we'll get skidding. really tight through here, but I think we can make it. It's just we've got a big pull of a long hill ahead. As you can see, the horizon up above us is probably about, I don't know, 50 feet up. Not much, but enough. Incline starting to happen now. Have to be very careful not to damage the base of any of the other trees that are left. Cause problems in their future. Knock off their value as a timber resource, timber tree. I think we're going to do it. We're now about at the base of the hill. There we go. Start to see the angle of the trees against. As we're starting to climb. We'll get there, I hope. Coming to their own as well. Beautiful office on a good day. On a bad day, however, it can get really expensive. New tyres, one puncture. What a beggar. Here's one I prepared earlier. I actually forgot I owned 17 meters, like a nail. Old cricket pavilion. And here we are, it's the top out, top three sections. Another smaller tree actually already ready to go home. And a spaniel ready to go home by the look of it. Hey there, Moll. Good girl. Yeah, you are, aren't you? It's all good. Let's get the next one. Bits, but we'll have to come back for the last bit and a tick. See if we can pick this all up. Two more, one to go. Bit. I've lived in the Wensum Valley in Norfolk all my life. I suppose you could say it's my own little Appalachia. And this little valley, you can see the river down the bottom there, has given me pretty much everything I've ever needed. Been about a bit. But it's beautiful, just coming from here. A lot of people say about Norfolk people that we're a bit thick, we're a bit, I don't know, old-fashioned. Maybe we are. I don't much care what people think, really. I know I'm happy to be part of this beautiful valley. Funny, really. We're now at a time when everyone's really upset about where they belong. It's a shame we don't realise we all belong together. Maybe if you did start realising that, you'd start realising it doesn't matter what gang you're in. We're all on the same planet, all in the same valley. Just a thought. See you now. Bye.